everyone, you're watching Propersonify with Bhakti. In case if you're new here, consider subscribing to the channel. Also, do press the bell icon so that you get notified about all my upcoming videos. While I was on the breakfast table in the morning today, my family was discussing about some wedding, upcoming wedding in my family, and they were discussing about all the rituals and traditions related to that. That reminded me of a story that I had been told about when I was a child. And it really makes sense, you see. The story goes this way. There was a pretty big family, and there was a tradition in this family. There was a ritual in this family which must be followed no matter what. And the ritual was, the tradition was, or the belief was, that whenever there would be a wedding in the family, they needed to get hold of a cat and hide it under a basket. Sounds weird, isn't it? Now, we all have such weird beliefs, or to be more precise, blind faiths that we actually follow blindly. We don't know where it came from and where it's going to take us, and how practical it is, and why does that need to happen? Coming back to the story, they had to hide the cat, yeah, under the basket. Now, everybody in the family, all the generations, kept on following the same faith or belief, you know, because somehow they believed that the marriage wouldn't work out, the marriage would be devastated if they did not hide the cat under the basket. Now, there was this young gentleman in the family who was supposed to get married, and he came to know about this belief or this faith in the family. This young gentleman was inquisitive enough, and he spoke to his father about it. His father sent him to his grandfather. He spoke to his grandfather about it. His grandfather sent him to his great grandfather, who was thankfully alive as well at that time. So he spoke to his great grandfather around about the same topic, and thankfully he came to a conclusion. His great grandfather said that when he was a child, he saw this incident. There was a family in the wedding, and the great-grandfather's grandfather was taking care of the kitchen, and there was a cat who was moving around the kitchen where the huge utensils with steaming hot foodstuffs were lying on the floor. So she could have either got hurt or lost her life if she fell into the vessel, hot vessel, or she could have destroyed the things lying around in the kitchen, and they were food items, so it was not good enough to let the cat move around freely in the kitchen. So what his grandfather did is, he caught hold of the cat, and in a corner of the kitchen he put a heavy basket upside down on top of her. So she was trapped. Basically, he'd take care of her and the foodstuffs. So this was observed by that little child, who was the great grandfather of this new groom. So what he concluded from all the discussion that he had with his great-grandfather was that his great-grandfather, when he was a kid, he observed this incident and it got captured in his mind. And he asked his grandfather, why did you do that? Why did you hide the cat? And his grandfather answered him, if I did not hit the cat, she would have devastated the entire wedding. He meant that she would have devastated the kitchen or the food items, not the wedding on the whole, you see. And this little child absorbed this as something else. He actually thought that she would have devastated the wedding, and he grew up with the same thought, and he practiced this ritual in all his weddings that happened, in all the weddings that happened in the family. So it became a tradition. So everybody started following this tradition so blindly, without even getting to the root of it, that how did this happen and why did this happen and what would happen if it did not happen. So finally the gentleman concluded that it was only his great grandfather's misunderstanding that they had to hide the cat, and there was no actual logic behind that. All I mean to say is, we all have certain beliefs and myths that we believe that they must happen, if they don't, there's something really wrong going to happen. I would suggest all of you that there is a very fine line between devotion and blind faith. It's good to be devoted. It's really divine to be devoted. But as long as you get everything in the right sense, there is nothing prescribed by any divine power, no rules as such that this is bad or that is wrong, and obviously, no life is bad. Animals are not bad. They cannot cause you harm unless you are protective about them and protective about yourselves. There are no myths. So before we give up or give up to any blind faith, use the gray matter within. Think about it and think how relevant it is. Without disturbing your divine beliefs, I do not mean to hurt your divine feelings. I believe in God. I believe blindly in Him and His presence. But certain things, we need to use our brains, especially when the technology has taken over. So while the technology has taken over wildly, the world is growing with artificial intelligence. People are becoming smarter. Let us become smarter as well. Give it a thought. Think about it. Think logically. And if you like this thought, do let me know. So you have a wonderful day ahead. Bye for now.